Hi, this is Scott Hanselman, and I'm taking a look at the Visual Studio 2013 JavaScript editor. I went up on CSS Deck and found a very lovely example from a gentleman named Emil Mahler. This is a product sample. As you hover over, you get a nice transition, the buy now, you get a flyout. It's really a great example of an interplay between HTML5, CSS, and JavaScript. I wanted to take a look at the JavaScript specifically. If you look here in the index.html, I've got jQuery, and then I've got his JavaScript. And if we look at the JavaScript, it's pretty straightforward. He's got some mouse enters and some mouse leaves. If I hover over them, you see that nothing's really happening. If I right-click on them and say go to definition, it says I can't find that definition. What I can do, though, is I can let this JavaScript know that we're using jQuery by just literally just dragging jQuery up here and adding a little comment. Notice how it now says reference. So it knows that I'm using jQuery. And you'll notice in here we've got a couple different versions of jQuery. We've got the main development jQuery. We've got the minified version of jQuery. There you go. All on one line there. We've got the source map. And then the IntelliSense files. And these are really nice. These have added comments at the beginning of each function in order to give you help on your JavaScript. And you can make these yourself for your own JavaScript. So just by adding that reference at the top there, suddenly, if I go and do a jQuery object, I've got IntelliSense. I've got operator overloads. I've got IntelliSense. Let's see here. We'll go and do something. Dot remove class. And then I've got help. This help text is coming directly out of that IntelliSense file. Even better, I've got go to definition support now, so I can right click and say go to definition. And notice that it jumps me over to the IntelliSense file, not the minified version, just by virtue of the fact that it has that name. And there's the function signature information. Again, you can make those yourself. It's a really nice feature. And you can get those IntelliSense files for lots and lots of libraries, not just jQuery. They're just text files. You can make them yourself. They're really nice. Another thing I could do, I've got some commented out JavaScript at the bottom here. I'm just going to use a hotkey, Control K, Control U, to uncomment that. The new JavaScript editor in Visual Studio has support for ECMAScript 6 stuff like the const and let keywords. See, that shows up there as well. And because we're actually using the Internet Explorer JavaScript engine inside of the editor. And you'll notice the use of let here, where we've got a var, but let is allowing us to have a reduced scope. So there's lots of cool stuff in 2013 in the JavaScript editor. Take a look at the other videos for the CSS editor and HTML editor to get a sense of all the stuff that front-end web developers can do with 2013. I hope you enjoy it.